Hello everyone, and welcome back to the actual episode 19 of my Roma Surrectum 2.5 Pontus campaign. This is Syspon. Let's get to it. Okay, well, I believe we started our war against Pergamon. We have one army over here holding this river crossing. And our second one just took Tavion. Let's start the script here. And this army's still in pretty darn good shape, so we just need a garrison to hold Tavion behind us. Which, I wonder if Epimae could reach it in one turn. Yes, it can easily, but it can't really make much. And if, say, Mazica could reach it, it can't, darn it. Okay. Heraclea, maybe? Nope. Okay. Ain't no use to here. So yeah, we'll probably just make a little garrison at Apamea here. And then we can make some other troops to hold it that aren't going to get there the next turn. But they'll get there soon enough, it won't really matter. Okay. We might need a governor for there as well. Let's see if we have any spare governors sitting around here. I think we've got a couple over here at Amasia. See, we can maybe use this guy. He looks pretty good. We might move him to a better city once we get it, like, say, Pergamon or something, but for now, he can hold Tavion. We also have one... We just finished training a general here. I want to see if there was somewhere we were sending him first, though. Well, everywhere over here looks good. Hierapolis is our only place without a governor currently. Maybe that's what I made him for. We'll send him that way. And he can't quite reach it, but oh well. Tarsus is not very happy with us, so let's see if we can't build something there to fix that. I don't think we're at the population growth right now. We want to get a lot happier before we get it growing too much. So let's just go ahead and build something cheap to increase its happiness. We could build Egyptian mummification that gives us 5% happiness bonus and actually an increase in tax for once. No. Doesn't look like we really have access to anything that's going to give us a lot. Maybe... Because this is just bumping it up a little bit. It's not actually the full 15. It would give us... Yeah, another 5% just like everything else. So yeah, we'll just go ahead and build Egyptian mummification here for now. But we're going to have to sink some money into there to get it happy. Same with Apamea, probably. Well, we could always lower taxes at Apamea and be just fine. I think we'll do that. I don't know why we have them on very high anyways, unless we're trying to purposely slow down the growth. Which is possible. Okay. Yeah, they've definitely got a lot of troops here. Some of them are actually fairly experienced, but it doesn't look like they have very many elite troops built yet. So we should still be able to overpower them. Okay, I think we are ready to end our turn here, just to be sure, check all our agents.
Your honor.
Diplomat, you can just chill there for now, I think.
Yes, master.
And I like this guy where he is keeping tabs on that. So, let us end our turn. Ptolemy's trying to bribe me. Seleucids are back. Hello.
We are under siege.
Holy moly, are the Seleucids back. Come on, guys. Keep them busy for me. Good lord. Well.
We are under siege.
This could have gone better.
Splitting the troops.
Oh, yay, and my national leader died as well, so now I have no general here. Fortunately, I have some other people waiting in the wings. We're going to go ahead and send him out. Let our other guy take command here since he's only 16. I'd rather let him grow up a little bit, gain some traits first. So, Satalis besieged by Armenia, Hierapolis by Armenia. Good lord, this is going to get messy, guys. We're not really making enough money to really raise a whole other army or anything, unfortunately. He's got pretty good troops there, too. Okay. So this guy is our new national leader. Sorry, give me just a second to decide what to do here, guys. Yeah, that's our new one right there. While we're thinking about it, let's go ahead and split that garrison up for us.
My lord! My lord! Onward!
You guys leave.
Orders! Forward! My lord!
And you're still extremely unhappy, so we'll move you to low taxes, but we should have the rest of your garrison here pretty shortly, so don't be too pissed. Hopefully they leave well enough alone. Whew, okay, so now we get to the hard part. Well, the good news is we're not dealing with an emergency army here at the moment. So then, hopefully we won't have cataphract elephants or scythe chariots for us to deal with, so we might be able to take care of this with what we have.
My lord! Yes, strategos! March! Sir, onward!
And as far as Armenia goes, that's a tougher one. They are going to have tough units in there. We could try to just gather the troops we have here and kind of mix them into a cohesive army. I might make a cheap garrison unit or two here. And send these guys over to a major to upgrade. And try to get some kind of army put together from this. Oh. These guys would be awesome. I was trying not to use them yet. Just because it's a little early in the game, but I'm considering it. They would give us some cheap infantry that would actually let us fight back a little bit. Oh, it's tempting, it's tempting, it's tempting. Does anyone desperately need some building? No? Okay, then we're not going to worry about building this turn. One of you guys, you'll probably lead the assault over here.
Yes, Stratagos.
What else do we need? We could probably use a couple units of horse archers, since I know they're going to have some. Let's build two of them. I know we could use some heavy cavalry. Do you guys have a... Not really. You don't have a decent armory yet. So anything I'd build for you would have to be retrained up here first. Okay, we'll build two of these guys as well. And we might take another turn to build one of these units of heavy cavalry, and then we'll head this way. Hopefully in time to, at the very least, take this back. We'll see what happens, though.
My lord.
I think for now, jeez, they definitely reinforced all their cities. So this is not going to be just an easy campaign here. Well, thanks to all that, we may have bitten off more than we can chew. And I can basically guarantee they wouldn't take any kind of ceasefire we offered. Yep. We did start the war after all. I mean, our best bet might be to get them to attack us at one of these crossings and just whittle their forces down.
March.
And hopefully we can, in that way, reduce their forces enough that we can take those cities. But there's only so many river crossings, and there's no guarantee they're going to attack us there when we want them to. And there aren't really any in this direction, which sucks. We'd have to go right up to here, which we can't quite reach this turn.
Sir.
And I'm going to move him right around here just so we can strike in either direction if we need to. I mean, if they leave one of those cities ungarrisoned, I do have catapults, so I can just kind of sneak in and take it out from under them. And we can slowly win the war in that way still if we need to. Rebels, you guys are just going to have free run of it for the moment. I'm a little too busy to deal with you. Wonder where the music isn't going. Could just be that it's the typical Eastern music glitch this mod gets. We might as well fight one of these Seleucid stacks here. Make a quick save, and then let's have a battle. We'll take the smaller one out first. Lovely, they've got a lot of heavy cavalry. That could be problematic. I might want to save my javelin troops to take them out once they're engaged. Or my slingers could do it. We'll see. I think we can take this regardless. Let's go. Alright guys, I think I have my army set up how I want. Now it's just time to start this battle and see what happens.
Units!
Gods be praised! The reinforcements are here! Send them to fight! Dishearten the enemy!
Head this way. Check out what they have really quickly. Okay, we've got some hypaspists here. Levy, Palmyran Phalangites, Pizzadoroi, Heavy Peltists. All their heavy cav is lined up here. This will be a fantastic fight. Takabara, and some Eastern type archers. Okay. Well, at least they're not going to terribly overmatch us in infantry. We might actually have the edge there. At least as far as numbers go, they are on a bit of a hill. I wonder if we can kind of take them from the flank here. We are close to the edge of the map there, though, so no, that's not going to work. Why is it doing that? Probably because it's all marching. Okay. Well, we'll let everyone get into position here. Oh, did it mess it all up? Are you kidding me? Alright, guys. Stop, you retards. Why would you do that? Let's get back into formation here. Sorry guys, I'll just get back to you when this is all fixed. I think I accidentally selected this reinforcement unit when I told them to march in formation and that messed the whole thing up. So I'll be right back. Alright guys, this is going to be interesting. They are kind of... No, they were starting to rush me. It looks like they're pulling back, so I should be able to get into position here. So we'll see what happens. They're being a typical AI, running forward and backwards, so I'm going to have my troops go back to walking. If they do rush me, I will try to run into formation, but I don't want to tire myself out before the battle here, so go ahead and triple speed it for now, see what happens. Okay. Now I'm thinking they might actually be trying to rush us here with only part of their army, which is stupid of them, but annoying as hell for me. So let me get lined up, you bastards. Alright, one second here. General, see if it'll let me do this time. No, maybe. Get off my screen, please. Okay, yeah, what I need to do is drop these two guys out of the group. In fact, just drop the cavalry. I just need to get my infantry lined up. Okay. Can you guys just line up, like, right here for me? And you guys can come back this way. You can head over here. And you guys can stop where you are. Just line up, like, right here. And drop your spears. They have no idea what they want to do. But they did kind of force me to come at them from the angle I wasn't looking forward to. Let's turn my archers off. I don't want to waste their fire yet. At least I want to pick my targets. Well, you know what? They're coming down into the plain to fight me somewhat, so I can deal with this. Go ahead and move our units up to about here. Come on, guys. Work with me. You know what? If they're going to back off, I'm just going to keep moving this way like I wanted. Sorry, I know this is just kind of a lot of annoying maneuvering here, but they're not giving me much of a choice. And I'd skip past it, but I have no idea when the actual battle is going to start at this rate, so you'll just have to bear with me for a little bit, guys. See if we can't finish getting up on even ground here. I'll leave you guys over here. You'll be on the flank by the time everyone moves over. Alright, guys, basically here now. Cool. Alright. Get some close-ups of our army in the meantime for ya. Okay, and it looks like they are going to let me line up this time. So we'll have at least relatively even terrain to work with here. Much better than what we were going to have, at least. And they're taking a couple pot shots at me, but it's gonna happen. I can't really do anything about their archers right now, unfortunately. Except for maybe getting my other archers into formation and fire back. Go ahead and run them. I don't think I need this group at this point. Oh, come on, really? What? Thank you. They have the hill advantage a little bit with their archers, so we can't really fire back on them yet. But they're moving around, so we're not really taking any shots in anyways at the moment. Oh. Apparently they offered up their hypaspists as sacrifices. Though they might be supporting them with some heavy cavs, so we might not be able to take them out as quickly as I'd like. Okay, now while they're pulling back, I'm going to see if I can just crush these guys here really quickly. These are probably the toughest infantry unit that we're going to face from them. So if we can get them out of the way now, this will make this battle a little bit easier. I never was really sure why the AI did this. I'm definitely ready for Rome to hopefully has much better battle AI than this, but you know what? We'll suffice until then. Let's kill him. Hopefully we get an actual charge off here. And it looks like one of our units did at least, and wow. Yeah, that took care of business. Alright, well, let's just line them back up here. No point in tiring them out. And let's go ahead and advance. Still going to have a slight hill advantage this way, but not nearly as bad as coming from that direction, so I'm happy. Alright, well, now we have a decided infantry advantage. All they really have left is their phalanxes and their Takabara, unless they have one hidden that I'm not remembering. And they're dealing some slight damage with those archers, but nothing we can't deal with. Okay, good. I'm in range to fire back, so I'm going to take these guys out as quickly as possible. This is the big threat they have left right here. Not too worried about the rest. Right, they have those heavy peltists, but I'm not too worried about them. How are my archers doing? Not bad. Not as good as they could be if they were on even ground, but they're starting to take them out a little bit. Here comes their cavalry. We're definitely going to want to intercept those here, so let's pull back. This could be messy. For sure. What are you guys doing? Alright, well, let's go ahead and take advantage here and swing around the flank since they're gonna be weird and give up the hill. I'm not going to complain too much over that. Good lord, this unit is just getting absolutely demolished. Let's try to get some javelins in here while we can. Okay, now you guys pull back to here. And let's get our... Are they retreating? Gosh darn it, guys. Freaking pansies. They're just gonna run the F away. Units, double time. Well, that was disappointing, guys. That unit just straight up crumbled. But, I mean, against a couple units of cataphracts, that's what's gonna happen. This is basically just a matter of clean up while they run away. I might even try to get some javelins in their back with these guys. But aside from that, this battle's over. I can't stand it when the AI just runs away like this. Stand and die like a man.
The gods have filled
Of course, I ran away from battle last episode, I think, too, but that's different. Like a coward.
The enemy general is slain, and now his men fear us. It is time to press the attack.
Okay, yeah, so this is over. We'll just triple speed it here. They're off the side of the map. I can't do anything about it. And let's go ahead and just end the battle.
Gods be praised. Well, this victory is surely their work, not that of mortals like us.
We still definitely came out of it ahead, but I would have liked to just crush that, period. Nah, it's just going to be that much sooner until they send another army at me. Oh, sorry guys, I almost forgot to restart the recording. We're just going to go ahead and send him back here for now. Retrain this army back up a little bit. Man. They're not going to just take this easy on us, that's for sure. Oh, forget sending him there. There's no point in just sacrificing him. Send him to Tarsus for now. This army... You know what? Looks a little bigger, but at the same time, I don't see any cataphract units. It doesn't mean they're not there. I'm just hoping one of these... four units we can't see isn't something scary, like a cataphract elephant unit. Well, this is definitely going to get interesting. In a good way. That just makes things exciting for you guys, right? I'm going to try to save my money and not build buildings right now unless I have to, just because of the crazy... all-front war that I'm going to have to be fighting here for a little bit. As soon as I take Pergamon out, all I'll have is these two cities as borders here on this entire flank, and I'll be able to focus my military might over here to take care of these threats. I'll probably just keep holding the defensive flank here and then try to take out Armenia, but that's a bit in the future. I think for now we're good to go ahead and end our turn, though. Not a lot else for us to do. So, let's do it. And the Seleucids are back. That's just that army that was at the south, I believe, now. If that's a whole other army, we're in trouble, but I don't think it is. Mazica grew, so we're just going to have to save some money to do that as soon as we can. Might have to spend some of it on troops, but we're not going to do any big building before that. Let's try to get an army set up here.
My lord.
Gosh, I really need some more infantry to go with this.
Sir, my lord. Yes, Strategos. Sir.
It's five units right there.
My lord.
Is he the one? Yeah. Perdiccas of Amasus, you will control this army.
Yes,
and...
Sir, my lord, forward! Warders! Sir, forward! Warders! My lord, my lord, my lord!
Not going to have much of a garrison here. I might make one unit of Thraki just so I have some heavy infantry there. Well, that's a waste of money. I don't think it's going to be attacked. I dearly hope it won't be. And will this be enough? I'm not at all sure. They do have some rams, though, so I think I need to get over here regardless. Gosh. We might be better off waiting another turn, getting a little bit of a better army, and if they take it, we retake it. But we'll be in better shape to do it. I think that's going to have to be our plan. So, in that light, we need some heavy cavalry to bring that way. So we're making two Cappadocians here. And we could make Scythian Royals, but it's fun to mix it up. They're basically the same stats. These guys are expensive. But we do need some. Oh. I don't know how much more infantry we need. Maybe one or two more units. But against Arminius, it's really, really nice to have good cav, because they definitely will be bringing some serious cavalry muscle in. Got plenty of archers, so that's not a problem. Spearmen would be nice. Let's go two units of Thrakatai.
My lord.
And that should fill that army up enough. Okay. So we'll give them one more turn and then head that way. Let's go ahead and sink this fleet blockading our port here. Pretty sure that's the whole reason we made this fleet, now that I think of it.
We are victorious! Set sail!
And we're still saving up some money towards Mazika's growth. Might not happen very fast, but it's not really expanding. So it's not too much of a rush. It's not going to go crazy out of control squalor for a while. No cities left unguarded here.
My lord.
No one attacked my lovely little river army.
Sir.
I can hold this river crossing as well and see if they attack.
Move out. Prepare to ambush.
I'd love to just start whittling away their military forces, but if we want to maximize our kills and minimize our casualties, well, we gotta be a little cheap, I guess.
My lord.
You guys go into Tavian.
Move out.
Oh, we might as well go for them now.
Sir.
Why does this army get out of order? Let's see.
Sir. Onward. Yes, Strategos! Sir! Sir! Onward! My lord!
You
yes,
go there.
Strategos!
You go
yes,
there.
Strategos. My lord! Yes, Strategos!
You sir, go here.
My lord!
And you go here. Oh, he's in the way.
Sir! Onward! Sir!
Now you go there. Okay. We're going to give this one more go, and regardless of what happens, this will probably be the end of the episode.
Prepare for battle.
Maybe they will actually stand and fight. Who knows? Okay, good. Nothing scary, just lots of troops here. Really, it's a lot of light troops with just a couple of better troops mixed in. So I think this will be a, maybe not an easy win, but not going to be anything too crazy for us. Alright guys, I've lined up here on the extreme left, and wow, for once the AI surprised me and did not just line up on the biggest hill it could find. At least not yet. We're going to assume they're going to head this way though and just march over this way. I'm not worried about taking the hill advantage myself, but I'd rather deny it to them at least. I should be able to get my cavalry out on the wings now. I was kind of forced to keep them squished in due to the deployment zone being kind of cramped there in the corner. Alright, and let's just triple speed this. Get everyone into place and then march in. And while this is going on, let's take a look at their army here. A lot of skirmisher, javelin-type units, peltasts, acantistae in the front. Solid phalanx line, a little bit of cavalry on each flank over there, and some archers in the back, I think. Yep, but they're just plain Greek archers, so it's not too scary. Alrighty, I think we more than have this battle. Alright, I'll get back to you guys when we're about to engage here. Alright guys, we are pretty close. The battle's gonna start here, at least the skirmish phase, pretty quickly. I think we're gonna go ahead and start shooting up their skirmish units here a little bit, screen our army somewhat. We should be able to mow them down. At the very least, it's some nice easy experience for our archers. Let's see. Okay, look, gotta pull this cavalry back. They're rushing it here. Bring it this way, and let's try to trap them a little bit. Alright, they went ahead and backed off here, so let's go ahead and just keep pushing in. We're melting those skirmish units pretty good. Let's go ahead and get a couple shots here on this companion cavalry of the Seleucids. Okay, it looks like our army's reached where it needs to be. Let's go ahead and get back into some kind of formation here quickly, guys. It's just gonna make you easier to move around. Let's go ahead and move our archers up a little bit, though. Looks like they are starting to get a little bit of fire going with their archers here. So let's go ahead and advance our lines forward here. Nope, nope, nope. Stop it. Right there. Oh, let's go ahead and take them out. Oh, nope, wrong unit. Crap. You just line up with everyone else here. You guys just go right about to there. Just walk right through them and go there. You guys right here. Units, move out, archers. We're under attack. Okay, well, we're working on those archers. In the meantime, you guys go ahead and move up here. Units, mark, and let's start playing some havoc over here. Generals advance to here. Slingers. You know what? Let's try something here. We're gonna see if we can't be a little tricky on this flank. Same time, let's push up here. Perfect, they took the bait over here. So in the meantime, we are going to swing right up here on this flank. Let's engage their phalanx line here before they start maneuvering too much. Basically taking care of their heavy cavalry on this flank. That's perfect. Oh, come on. Stop retreating and face us, noobs. Let's see. Use our slingers to go ahead and annihilate these guys if we can. Perfect. Take them out really quickly, guys. Are they engaging our phalanx line? It looks like they are for the most part. Perfect. Okay. Swing our heavy cavalry around this way. What's going on there? Oh, my peltasts. You guys go this way. Where are you guys? This way? Okay, come here. I'm not worried about them. What are you doing? Okay, let's go ahead and zoom around the flank here. We can easily start getting some shots into their backs. Where do you think you're going?
The enemy. Great God, be praised! The enemy general is killed.
Okay.
Fear makes a home in our enemies' hearts.
Got our slingers right over this way. You guys go help against... Oh, never mind. They're gone already. Perfect. Chase them down. So yeah, let's take out this unit first here really quickly. This is going pretty perfect here. You guys can swing around this flank a little bit. Get some javelin fire in there. And slingers, go ahead and... One volley should take these guys out, hopefully. At least get them routing. There we go, perfect. Swing around, face this direction. You guys chase that unit down. You guys just go ahead and worry about routers as well. Said, line up, please. You fire there. You fire there, and you fire there. And this battle should be over in a couple seconds for us. Let's go and get some close-ups here of this carnage. Huh. Oh, there's one broken. Oh yeah, this should start a chain right here momentarily. You guys switch targets to here. You guys go to here. How can you not hit that? Oh. You're flip-flopped. So you go there and... Oh, you're running. Perfect. Okay. And this is basically down to clean up here. I think some of them are just fighting to the death. I don't think anyone's actually still not routed. That I can see, at least. You guys get... Oh, okay. I will see you guys at the end result screen here. That was about as simple as I thought it'd be.
Worthy of Greek soldiers.
Alrighty. Let's see how it turned out. Probably just a clear victory here, yep. Oh, yeah. They pretty much got slaughtered. Way too much light troops and not enough infantry or cavalry support. Slingers didn't do near as much damage as they could have, but they broke so quickly they didn't really get the chance. Archers did good damage. Obviously, my cavalry chased on the routers. Wow, that... One casualty and 120 kills. I think you guys win. Well, maybe the archers, but still. I don't see phalangites usually do that great offensively, but that was pretty fantastic. Okay, it looks like my fraps derped out right after that battle, but I don't think we missed anything. I hadn't done anything. So, yeah, that's over. Really, I mean, I could use a little bit of retraining, but that army's still in pretty good shape after killing that one. Way better than... just what those couple units of heavy cavalry did to me in the last one. I think we'll save it here, and next episode or two is going to be very eventful. We're going to have to deal with the Armenians in multiple areas, See if Pergamon attacks us during the end turn phase, which I'm not going to do now, or this would be another hour. And yeah, it's just going to be fairly exciting. So, thanks for watching, everyone. I will see you guys next episode.